Duncan Minuch have it figured out.
Yeah, I got it.
No one really listens to sports radio for X's and O's. They might listen to post-game shows or maybe even to a coach's show.
Makes me want to pee.
But what they do want is to be entertained.
That's the smartest thing I've ever heard anyone say about anything.
And Calling All Sports with Rock and Minuch is your home for all your sports entertainment. Whether it's with Rock and Minuch arguing with each other, blowing up the callers with sound effects, or bantering with their guests, it's sports with entertainment, and in many cases, entertainment with sports. Guy Radio, a locker room for grown-ups, or better yet, pseudo-grown-ups. You've been waiting all day, and now it's 5 o'clock and it's happy hour. Your drive home sports alternative getaway is underway with Calling All Sports with Rock and Minuch, powered by 1-800-LAWYERS on the Fan, AM 1060.
Good life.
507 Rock and Minuch, your drive home sports alternative, presented by our good friends over at Pro Baldwin and Shield. See, I was wondering if you knew that.
Absolutely.
Without looking at your lineup.
Pro Baldwin and Shield. We've been beating that up for a long time.
Just double checking.
Absolutely.
You know? Or 1-800-LAWYERS. We're out here at Phoenix Municipal Stadium, the home of the Oakland Athletics, as they had their first game today, and they will go at it again tomorrow at 1 o'clock against the Indians, and then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Yes. Well, that's a long homestand for our fine folks here that are working here at Phoenix Municipal Stadium. We do want to congratulate Trevor Croker from Phoenix and Bob Perdue from Peoria, who won tickets by calling in. So we invite you to come on out. Say hello to Travis when you come out here, Key. If you go up to Travis and say hello to him, he'll allow you to run the bases with the team. Yes.
Is that where Gamer's been the last half
hour? And throw out the first pitch.
Yeah.
And, kind of get the balls ready, as well as maybe manage a couple innings.
So Travis is actually working out here.
Travis does it all for
that boy, Travis.
Good stuff there. We're here next Tuesday as well. But again, go to oaklandathletics.com/spring. Is your best bet, and you can order your tickets. I will tell you this, this Saturday is already a sellout with the Giants, as you can only imagine, the Battle of the Bay. So, again, you have tomorrow the Indians, Rangers on Friday, and then Brewers on Sunday, Mariners again on Monday, Padres on Tuesday. And just looking ahead, make sure you mark your calendars down for St. Patrick's Day, as it's always an annual event here, as the Cubs and A's we'll go at it on the 17th.
Yeah, we were privileged to be here last couple of years at St. Patty's Day. That's a big crowd going on.
Doug Plank will join us at 25 minutes past the hour, but we're talking about the Phoenix Coyotes. They do play the Dallas Stars today. There's a story that came out this afternoon that has to do with the Dallas Stars. Now, Hockey News is reporting that a oil man, Douglas Miller, has made an offer to purchase the Stars because they're up for sale.
Yes.
So they're dealing with some of the same stuff. Mark Cuban is also one of them, the billionaire with the Mavs. And supposedly, according to the story, is this Douglas Miller is known in the business circles as a stalking horse. He's someone who kind of established the value of a business by making an offer before another party comes in with a more lucrative one. So the guy kind of plays the system. But in any event, the offer is believed to be about $110 million cash. Goldwater, buddy. Goldwater Institute. Yeah. Get over there to Dallas.
Who's the watchdog?
Have some fun out
Who's
there.
Who's that watchdog in Dallas watching that
but,
movie?
I guess publicly they'll announce it somewhere around $225 million because in addition to their purchase price, they have some existing money challenges, yes. Mm-hmm. And they also owe the NHL some money for an advancement of some television and revenue sharing. This is all according to Hockey News. So they also have had a bunch of losses over the last 4 years, estimated about $25 million a year. So it's not all just the Phoenix Coyotes are having problems in the Atlanta Thrashers like we talked about last week. I'll talk some football, though. This is one of the best quotes that I've heard in a long time. This has to do with Carson Palmer, Cincinnati Bengals disgruntled quarterback, declared this, quote, "I will never set foot in Paul Brown Stadium again. I have $80 million in the bank. I don't have to play football for the money. I'll play it for the love of the game, but that would have to be elsewhere," close quote.
Don't ever say never, Carson, because you just never know when you can come back around. He's spreading the base if retired. I mean, that's what I get out of
it. Why not? He's got 8 million reasons to.
Why would you play?
I think it's great what he said. You don't like it.
No.
He just said don't be, you know,
because
be careful
what
you
say. What if he changes his mind, Rob? What if he decides I will play?
Then you eat crow. Big deal. We do it every day here. What's the big deal?
There's no problem with that, but something must have really happened, and nobody get to the bottom of why he's so adamant of never, ever going back to Paul Brown Field in Cincinnati again. But I think that you just have to be careful, because if he does want to play the National Football League again, and he's still got maybe several good years left in him, you know, you've got to be moved through Cincinnati. So you don't want to, you know, upset the people in front of you, unless you said, you know what, I'm done. I'm out of here. I'm done, and I'm moving on.
He could retire, right? And then after a year, he could play somewhere else.
Well, they still have his rights, so they still have his rights.
Maybe the Bengals wouldn't want his rights after a while if they find somebody.
I just think that you got to be careful, and if he's truly never going to play again, Cincinnati obviously would like to keep him unless they can put some kind of a package deal together and make it work.
There's a little bit of talk in the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel today that Matt Flynn may get traded by the Green Bay Packers. Matt Flynn. You know, he's been on the bench for Green Bay for a few years now, and you know, he's been a backup. He's got an 82.4 quarterback ratings, but only 146 snaps, so he hasn't gotten the opportunity to play either.
Yeah, they talk about the potential. He had a rough game when he came in for Aaron Rodgers in that Detroit game, and Rodgers got knocked out in the following game. I believe it was Monday Night Football. He played a pretty good game, got the team back into it, but. You know, Rock, when a guy like plays two games, you really don't get a good feel. You got to give a young quarterback, in this case, Matt Flynn, a young quarterback, the opportunity to see what he can do over a 5, 6, 7 game, maybe an entire season, to see how legit he is as a quarterback to go somewhere.
Heinz Ward, come on. He should retire.
Dancing with the Stars.
Dancing with the Stars. You're absolutely right. That's all I can say. T.O.'s reality TV show is coming back for a third season. I'm sure everyone's excited about that. It'll come live from Florida, South Florida, as he will tape it from Miami, because that's where he spends the offseason, at least this year. And it will be documented again, his search for work.
The search for work out there, what he's going to find. I mean... you look at this lockout, Rock, and you think, what are guys going to do? I think I was reading earlier, one of the guys is talking about maybe doing some wrestling, WWE, just going out there. I mean, hey, you know, they're not under contract. If they get locked out, they're free to do what they want to do. Those you look at the, especially if this team decertifies, all the players decertify from the union. I mean, are the owners going to be able to lock out if everybody decertifies? So there's only a couple more days left. Let's see what's going to happen.
This news is somewhat big, as a U.S. district judge has ruled that the NFL cannot have access to TV network money if a lockout goes into effect.
Rock, that's a bombshell.
That's a huge bombshell.
Bombshell. Just to
say, they were banking on that, the owners.
Yes, they were. I get what they call it, the special master who ruled in favor of the owners a few short weeks ago that David Doty, basically the district judge, has ruled against
the
owners. That's huge.
What
Rocky.
A twist in this, Manouche.
Well, maybe the owners will come and negotiate properly, try to get a deal done. Mara, the owner of the Giants, was the very first owner today, Rock. The only owner so far that has showed up for the mediation talks. So maybe with this ruling now by this district judge that says they are not able to receive the TV network money, all of a sudden they're going to go, well, wait a second. Now, can they appeal this thing? Absolutely, they can appeal it. But are you going to take this thing to a higher and higher court during your negotiations if you lock out? Now, are they going to take the risk of banking that they're not going to receive that TV money during a lockout? I mean, this puts some fire into the negotiations. Now, I'm glad to see this.
Yeah, the U.S. District Judge said, quote, the court overrules the special master's findings as to the NFL's breach of the SSA relating to its contracts with DirecTV, CBS, Fox, NBC, and ESPN, and holds that the NFL breached the SSA as to those contracts closed, quote. Now, the NFL's come back. Greg Aiello, the PR guy, has said that as we have frequently said, our clubs are prepared for the contingency of this decision included. Today's ruling will have no effect on our efforts to negotiate a new balanced labor agreement, close quote.
I think that they will motivate them to negotiate when you see that money pulled off.
What's the SSA?
I have no idea what that means, Rog. The special, who knows? I'm not going to try to speculate what that means, but I think more so than anything, this shows that the district judge, David Doty, has said, look, the ramifications that Stephen Burbank, who's a special master, and I don't know what a special master is, ruled was unfair and unjust, and they cannot receive any of those TV monies. And
okay, so SSA, Social Security Administration.
Okay. Well, again, that is some breaking bombshell news. So you got two more days to negotiate. Really, Wednesday.
This is a big victory for the union.
Absolutely, it's a big victory for the union.
Big victory for the union, but at the same time, come on, the owners are going to feel this and they're going to win.
But again,
it's hard to get past the U.S.
But Ron, trust me, these owners have got coffers full of money. They are billionaires. I mean that ploy of receiving the TV money. That's all well and good, but they've got contingency plans they talk about. Greg Aiello says here, as you mentioned, there's more plan A, plan B, plan C. The thing I'm going to be curious, though, the thing is really is tomorrow to see if the union, the entire union, decertifies to prevent a lockout by the owners. That's
so explain,
the only way.
Elaborate that a little bit more for myself and others to have a better idea what that exactly means.
If every player in the National Football League decertifies from the union, what they're saying is we are no longer a part of the union. We're no longer part of the National Football League's union. So that case in point, then the owners can't come back and lock out the union because there is essentially no union. So there's no union, so they can't lock out the players if there's no union. Because then you start to get the antitrust violations. And they're going, okay, I have the right to work. I'm not part of a union. You know, Arizona's a right-to-work state. You don't have to be part of a union to work. So if you decertify and you don't have a union, how can you lock us out since there's no union? Now, that's one of the bargaining chips that I think they're going to hold on to at the very end. But with this coming to fruition late this afternoon, it's going to be interesting to see how the NFL Players Association counters or jumps on this situation in effect here. So, you know, 48 hours. There's a lot that can happen in the next 48 hours in the National Football League.
Hey, real quick, as we messed up, we're being told right now. Real quick, our 25 is 5 question of the day. If you get this right, you get yourself a $25 gift card from Via Luna Mexican Cantina and a pair of A's tickets. And a pair of A's tickets, CJ. Let's throw that in. Since we didn't do this at the top of the five like we were supposed to.
And what year was Phoenix Municipal Stadium built? What year?
602-260-1060. And we'll throw in a pair of tickets as well. So good luck on that one. It's just a year. That's all we need.
It's the year.
Give us a year. You get it right, you win. Our 25 of 5 question of the day. 30. Thanks to Via Luna. Hey, coming up, the great Buckeye, the great Chicago Bear, Doug Plank will join us. Unfortunately, it's not going to be on a real high note, as we're going to talk about one of his
20
teammates who passed away, who will be honored by Notre Dame here. But I do have a number. I'm going to have some fun with him to start it. Of course, he's a Buckeye, and I can't stand Michigan, so we'll have some fun with that next. It's Rock Padooch. We have a fan in 1060.
Clear.